Hey guys, it's PrimeScore, and today I'm going to go through the configuration file, your server settings file, for your Minecraft server. So when we're in this file, I'm going to start at the top and work my way down. So spawn monsters, it's kind of self-explanatory. If this is set to enable, your world will spawn skeletons and zombies and the monsters of the game. So if you don't want monsters, disable it. Player versus player, if this is enabled, players can attack each other. Disable it if you want a more peaceful server. Hell world, enabling this allows the world, the nether world, to be used and loaded, allowed for it to be accessed. Disable that if you don't want your nether world to be even loaded. Online mode, enable this if you want only people who bought Minecraft to play your server. Set it to false if you want cracked clients to play your server. We have a video on that. Spawn animals. Enable to spawn sheep and pigs and cows. Disable it if you don't want animals. Protected spawn size. We have a video explaining what that means. Essentially, the bigger the number, your spawn, the bigger your spawn is protected from griefers. Whitelisting. Enable it if you only want a certain amount of certain selection of people to play your server. Disable it if you want everybody to join your server. Allow nether, this determines if people are able to use a portal to access the nether. If it's disabled, if people walk into a portal, they won't go anywhere, but you can still have your nether enabled and people are able to still go to that nether through a plugin if they teleport with that plugin instead of just using a portal for some reason if you want portals disabled. View distance is basically, it's how far the player can see in the server. So if it's set to 10, I won't be able to see like mobs or players outside of a range 10 from my view distance. For level seed, that's kind of obvious. If you need to generate a world, you enter your level seed that you want and it'll generate the world based on that seed. Allow flying determines whether or not you allow fly mods on your server. If it's disabled, if you're in the air for 5 seconds or longer, you'll automatically get kicked. If it's disabled, enabled, people are allowed to use fly mods and fly around, do whatever the heck they want. Game mode, this is kind of obvious. Set this to whatever the default game mode of your server is. If you want a creative server, adventure server, or spectator server for some odd reason, you can do that. Difficulty, kind of obvious too. Is a peaceful difficulty. It's like no monsters whatsoever. Hard is the hardest, where there's a lot of monsters and they do a lot more damage. So yeah. Server message is the message that displays on the server list in Minecraft. So it's like, oh, 1.8, join new update server, la la la, this is an awesome server, please join factions, RPG, all that. That's the server message. You can change that with fancy colors, whatnot. Max tick time. This is the max number of milliseconds that is allowed for one tick to occur. So if that tick lasts longer, default is 60,000, which is 60 seconds. So if one tick takes 60 seconds for it to go through, the server will shut down because there's something wrong. A tick shouldn't at all take that long. It should take like 1/20th of a second. Generator settings, that's if you want to change how your Minecraft world is generated when you load new chunks, like if you want more towns than normal, or if you want to spike your biome, or just all desert biome, you just input your stuff there. Force game mode, that forces the game mode, every time a player logs on, set this to true, and then people will be forced to the default game mode that the server is on. So if your game mode is set to survival, and this is set to true, then every time somebody logs in, they'll be set to survival. So if they log off as creative, they'll log back on as survival. Broadcast console to ops, that's if, like, for example, whenever the server saves or somebody does something and type in a command, that console message will be displayed in the ops chat in Minecraft. Enable query, you don't really have to worry about that, but that's for another video. It's basically allow access with data and whatnot. We'll explain it more in a different video. Player idle timeout, that's the amount of time before, if a player doesn't perform an action, then they'll get kicked in that certain amount of time. Op permission level, there's different stages of permission levels for ops. It's 0 through 4, I believe. each one, you can look it up. It has different variations of complete control for ops on the server. Snooper enabled, that just sends data to Mojang, whatever you want to call it, Microsoft, on just your player data, but like the system the server is running on and whatnot. Level type, you could do like flat world, normal world, that kind of level type determines like how your world is generated. Hardcore, set that to true if you want players to go to spectator mode when they die. So yeah, enable command blocks, false if you don't want command blocks, true if you want command blocks. Network compression threshold, not even going to explain it, you don't even need to worry about it. Resource pack, SHA-1, that works in tandem with resource pack. In resource pack, a link to your resource pack goes there. And then you can go to a SHA-1 generator and put the link, and then it'll give you this long code that you just input here. Basically, what that does is that instead of downloading the resource pack every single time you log on to the server, the SHA-1 will let the client know that the resource pack has updated. So it'll only download the new resource pack when it is needed. Max world size, don't mess with that. You don't need to touch that. It's basically how big the world can get. Spawn NPCs, that's like villagers. If you want no villagers, set that to false. Otherwise, set it to true. We already went over resource pack. Generate structures, those are like villages. Set that to false if you don't want any villages or pyramids or temples to be generated. Max build height, how high you will let players build. So you can change that. Default is 256. Use native transport. Setting this to true is the best setting, so don't change it really. It's just native transport allows for it to work in a Linux-based mode instead of trying to work through a different operating system. Prevent proxy connections. This setting this to false will not allow players from will not allow players to access your server from a VPN or a proxy. And the last one, able archon. Basically, that means enables remote access to the server files. So pretty much just keep that false as well. Most of these you don't have to touch, but I thought it would be great to go over it. Some of you have been asking for that. So yeah, if you have any questions, please check our videos first and then check or leave a comment in the comment section below. Otherwise, go to our website, shockbyte.com, send us a ticket. We'll gladly answer it. Anyways, thank you for watching and have a great day. Thank you.